The 9/11 family members who did not accept the victim compensation money continued to seek answers through the judicial system.
I respect the law very much, and I think the rights of the ordinary citizen are extremely important and should not be simply trampled on and forgotten because of the size of the event, and that's what I feel like is happening. We have a civil justice system that should be in place for me to get answers that I need.
As of yet, they have not had their day in court. Were cases for demolitions to be tried in a court of law, this may be the summation that you would hear.
Now you know some things about physics. Those towers collapsed at free fall speed. Not quite 15 seconds. The law of conservation of momentum would have predicted about 45 seconds had there in fact been resistance to the collapse at each floor. But there was no resistance. Because the only explanation for the first three steel frame buildings in the history of mankind to collapse as a result of fire, all on the same day, all in the same place, all at free fall speed, all diving symmetrically into their own footprint, ladies and gentlemen, has nothing to do with fire, but was in fact a controlled demolition. World Trade Center 7. Some of you didn't even know that there was a third building that had collapsed that day, but now you know. And you look at the penthouse just as it's about to fall, and that is the first thing that collapses. Ten times the amount of dust that could be explained by the gravitational pull of a collapsing, burning building of whatever size, 10 times. There was that steel frame building in Philadelphia, still there. The testimony of the firefighters, the police officers, battalion chiefs standing right there on the sidewalk outside of the building hearing explosions. That's evidence. That is evidence. The molten metal, in the basement of the ruins can only be explained by explosives. That is evidence. The infrared satellite photographs taken weeks afterwards of ground zero, where you see hot spots well in excess of 1,000 degrees weeks after the photographs admitted into evidence here, of the orange to red hot pieces of steel being carried off by these machines is evidence. Their job was to explain to us why the World Trade Center towers collapsed. That was their job. The focus of the investigation was on the sequence of events from the instant of aircraft impact to the initiation of collapse for each tower. For brevity in this report, this sequence is referred to as probable collapse sequence, although it does not actually include the structural behavior of the tower after the conditions for collapse initiation were reached. It's still standing up there, ladies and gentlemen. Well, brevity. That is cover-up. Evidence of the truth. Evidence of mass murder by this government. Evidence of the absence and failure of democracy in this country.
The Twin Towers were attacked in part for their symbolism, but their collapse has come to have a new significance in the post 9/11 world. When those towers came crashing down, they took with them the very foundation of our Constitution and the structure of our republic for more than 200 years. We either live constitutionally, or else those who exercise official power do so unjustifiably and must be removed. There can be no disputing the facts. We have lost important constitutional protections against invasion of privacy, the right to dissent, and arbitrary search and seizure. Taking away these essential protections has not made us any safer. Thomas Jefferson once said, "When the people fear their government, there is tyranny. When the government fears the people, there is liberty." Dorothy Thompson, a prominent journalist, political commentator, and a leading opponent of Hitler and 1930s fascism, stated, "When liberty is taken away by force, it can be restored by force. When it is relinquished voluntarily, by default, it can never be recovered." You know what you have to do. You know what you have to do. You know what you have to do. You know what you have to do.